was on watch with the DMO there the other night, and I said to him, well, sir, what about this craft exhibition? I mean, what's going to be on display and what kind of people make these things? He said, believe me, Judge, they're fucking strange people. He said, they'll have planes and trains and planes and trains. And suddenly from the EP come a cry, Petty Officer Marchant. He said, I used to make tractors. What do you mean, model tractors? He said, oh yeah, he said, Massey Ferguson's, David Brown's. He said, I make the fucking lot. He said, where are they now then? He said, well, he said, before I went to join up, my mum said to me, he said, you can't fucking make tractors. He said, all your mates will take the piss out of you. He said, I wish I'd known now. Anyway, then the switchboard fire. Then the switchboard fire occurred. DCHQ maneuvering, DMEO speaking. Visibility is down to 3 foot. Difficult to know what's going on. What's fucking new is the cry from the battle. Within 2 minutes, the fire was out. Visibility, however, was nearly zero. DCHQ maneuvering, DMEO speaking. The fire is out, but visibility is zero. We must, I feel, evacuate maneuvering. Wait, was the cry from PO Marchant as he got up and he ripped his EVS mask off and he took one deep breath, the smoke cleared. How the fuck did you do that? I said, easy, sir, I'm an extractor fan. Gentlemen, tonight... Sorry, Larry, you're waiting for this. Gentlemen, tonight, Paul Hutchinson's productions promise you the Sods opera of all Sods operas, and so it should be. Sponsored by Age Concern on their first day release, please show a warm welcome for our first singing act tonight, Cinnamon Frames.
Just for those of you who remember the last Sods opera, does anybody remember we did the Bob Dylan set, and the biggest cheer was when we surprised when we went up, obviously it was a joke from yourselves, because you couldn't hear us. So this time we've got the microphones, and we will do the same Bob Dylan set, only with the microphones, so you'll all be able to hear it. So, here we go again.
Well, there was supposed to be three of us. Hey, I've come last week. Dylan already, look at that. There was supposed to be three of us, but he wouldn't let us do any Dylan, so we tied him up. Okay.
I'll sleep.
We're not doing any fucking doing it. We shit last year, it'll be shit this year. Oh,
well,
even worse thing than it is.
It's Houdini Hardy, that guy's got out of the ropes.
Well, I had a microphone in practice.
Yeah, well, you'd be all right. We're going to tell you about that, John.
Really, who starts this one?
It's me.
Yeah.
next was do a few of the original Beatles words. Just mention that group just in case nobody recognises it. then we've got a few extra lines from an anonymous pen. It was a Taz really one.
He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to. Nowhere man, can you see me?
Sing along if you like.
This is John's big moment.
Thank you.
just a dream. That was just a dream. That's me in the corner. That's me in the spotlight. Losing my religion. Trying to be a you. I don't know if I can do it.
Another Lennon and McCartney thing. Keep announcing who the bikes. And most of the lads will be too young to remember them anyway, but I'm sure some of the senior citizens, senior race.
You're right the first time. Right. And you got the words, the chorus, for those of you who were too pie shattered by the programmes.
Chorus number one. Wobbly, wobbly.
Yeah, wobbly.
Such an awesome sight. One in three, one in four, one in the scan. Bollocks! How long should we get back home? One in three, one in four, where's who now? Bollocks! Why can't we all go back home?
Can't sing.
We all live riding in the submarine. Smokers crying, what a bloody fuss. Doctors taking readings and they're always high. Let's hit the roof and blow the smoke right up his ass. Stephen Kirby, all is forgiven. They're only joking, one that's much better than two. One in three, one in four, what's this man? Bollocks! How long till we get back home? One in three, one in four, where's we now? Bollocks! Why can't we all go back home? TVO's got problems with a dodgy disc. He's having trouble getting off his rack.
From the Zimmerman frame, you grow more Dylan.
Bless you.
with a B-13. I won't mention that again tonight, right? Maybe.
Bring it out.
Two matlows on a jolly in America. Right, I'm going to explain to you lot now, right, what a jolly is. What a jolly is, when you're on real submarines, right, you go around the world and you go into places, right, and they give you extra money, I mean, bucksheen money, right, and they call that subbies, all right? Yeah? So now they all get pissed and they're on a jolly. Have you got it? Right. Well, get your names down from Burton, you miserable bastard. Right? Because we are going to get pissed. I mean, let's face it, for fuck's sake, even the Chief Stoker got a shag there last time. Yes! Yes! Dear G. Barlow, no, anyway. These two matlows in a jolly in America. One was pale and one was black. I'm not allowed to say white because apparently I've been warned about racial discrimination, okay? Anyway, they've had a few to drink. In fact, they were shiters, okay? And they're walking across the road, jaywalking as they call it in America, and they get run over, two dead matlows. Well, they go up to heaven and the pale one gets there first and he meets St. Peter at the gates. Well, see, St. Peter says to him, what happened then, Jack? He said, well, I was down there with me mate Chalky. He said, we had a few to drink. Got run over jaywalking. And he said, I wonder if it'd be right if I come in. And he said, well, he said, have you been good all your life? Have you had any regrets? He said, well, he said, I've sort of been good most of my life. He said, I've had the odd piss up. He said, the only regrets I've got is I haven't spent all my subbies yet, but it's all right. He said, well, okay. He says, here you are. I said, come in. He said, here's a big pair of white wings. He said, go and sit on the right hand of God. He said, I'll do that. Begin. So he went and sat on the right hand of God. Up come Chalky. Same story again. Says to him, have you been a good boy all your life? Any regrets? He said, well, I've been good all my life. He says, the only regrets I got is I didn't use to help the other guy scrub out MS-1. Bad knees. That's okay. And he says to him, okay. He says, you can come in. He said, here's your big black pair of wings. He says, right. He says, do I sit on the right-hand side of God? He said, no, fly, you cunt. You're a bat. Our second act tonight consists of two distinguished gentlemen, recently released, I believe, from Sunnyvale Retirement Home, otherwise known as the Mod Main Building. Two very senior naval officers, Admiral Sir Mincing Smoothly, DSMOBRN, and Admiral Sir LP Blower, OBERN, with a very refreshing look at today's Royal Navy.
Welcome to the new series of Royal Navy Today. Over the next few weeks we shall aim to bring to you a taste of life in the Royal Navy. And I start firstly with a comment from my learned friend, Admiral Sir L.P. Blower, on the forthcoming weeks of invigorating discussion. Please, Admiral Sir L.P. Blower.
I was just thinking of something else then. You know, it didn't happen in my day. Never had television discussions on the state of the Royal Navy. We just press gangmen went to sea for 5 years on little pay and very poor food, and they got rid of them after the war.
So what you're essentially saying at this juncture is that nothing has changed.
Quite so, yes.
Well, that draws to a close a most interesting discussion on the state of morale in today's Royal Navy. And one final comment from my learned friend on how to improve this quality that is morale.
Just have some bite shit and Vaseline. A few officers in Portsmouth with expanding walls, and let's give some more car passes to civilians and forget about the matlows. We'll have some higher DMR for police dogs, and let's forget duty free for some areas. And not forgetting, let's sail on a Friday and return on Mondays.
Oh, yes. A fine insight there, I think. It's a fine idea that go a long way into understanding the problems of today's modern Navy. And by the way, do you see a man that's completely stark, raving mad, sitting on a park bench drunk in rags, dribbling with medals pinned to his ripped jacket?
I believe I've seen that poor, forlorn, forgotten old sailor. He was made redundant after 20 years in the service with no pension and no job to go to.
That's you, that is. You did that. You made him redundant.
Well, you see that Bozer Wiley?
Oh, yes, I know the fellow, the duvet weight world champion.
He can beat you at arm wrestling.
You see a Polaris submarine returning from patrol with a high creel number?
Yes.
No smoking for 8 weeks. Yeah. And then when it surfaces, you do an equalising charge. You then gas the battery. And then straight after, you add hydrogen to the loops. And then straight after that, you move pyro.
Well, yes, I have observed such conspiracies and underhanded dealings within the submarine service.
That's your idea of improving morale, maybe.
Well, you did that, and you didn't have any chalk ices, and then you unloaded 40 gross of them on day zero. Anyway, enough about us. You see that M.M. Baldessara?
I believe I perceived that wrecking with the flesh about his person.
He's slimmer than your girlfriend, he is.
You see that casing?
You mean Lieutenant Burke?
No, the bearded, stumpy one who looks like a serpent. No. The one that drives like Ayrton Senna.
I have experience that height deficient pursuit boy.
He's your vision lost to me.
I am far too low, man. Deeply hurt by the off-the-cuff remark.
Well, look, you see that DMEO in the movie?
The virtual reality officer.
Do you know what he's doing back there?
No.
Good, because neither does anyone else. He's the only one he is.
Wait. Have you ever walked past the wardroom in HMS Resolution and heard some of that new fandangled electronic music with screeching, shouting and weird noises?
Yes, that's heavy metal.
That's Big Vern's favourite music.
No, that's drug-induced bollocks.
You see these blank pieces of paper in my hand?
Yes, I can see the objects held in my hand.
That's the Wheels watch bill, that is. excuse me, don't forget the doctors.
Is he the one with the self-combusting shoes? Can you remember back to a time when you were doing your 11 plus and failing because your spelling was so bad? And you failed to get into grammar school?
Yes, I do remember those days of Jolly Japes and the boys' toiletries and their dorm. Oh, God.
Yes. Right. Well, back to the crappy writing. That's weekly orders of RSTM, isn't it?
Well, excuse me, but you see that nav chief on ship control when he's just coming up to PD?
Yes, I am aware of Harry Showerjob.
That's the highest you've ever flown, that is. That's the ideal of the Mile High Club, that is.
I don't think so, and do you remember that time in the afternoon when you're about 3 hours away from dinner and have nothing to do, and you're feeling a bit hungry and there's no food around?
Yes, I have experienced that, such a feeling, post-meridian. Quite frequently, actually.
Well, that's 4 o'clock, is that? Well, you know when you see a few people doing lots of jobs, never at home, underpaid, pissed off, in an industry with no ships or submarines?
No, I don't actually think I do.
Well, that's the Royal Navy tomorrow, that is. And you're going to do that, you're planning to do that already, you are.
Well, do you see those, the TLDs and neutron dosimeters?
What, the ones we're all supposed to carry you to tour? Yes, I am very aware of the orange Barbie suitcases.
Well, that's the Wheels, that is.
can remember the old Royal Navy. I can remember when Rab Stewart was a baby tiff. He's not in tonight, is he? Doesn't matter. You think he got big ears now, you should have seen him then. Not only did he have big ears, one of them was green. No, I can remember, it's a sad story, I can remember that Rab would never want to go ashore with us, you know, about his green ear, he was a bit embarrassed about it. So he said, look, Rab, unless you come ashore with us, you're never going to get into society. I said, I'll tell you what, I said, there's a bop on tonight, come down to bop with us. No, fuck, he said, I can't, he said, everyone will laugh at us, he said, just come down to fucking bop, you'll be all right. So he come down to bop with us, we're in the dance hall and the night's going on, not too bad, obviously no one's talked to him yet. And I spot this bird with a big fucking green lip. I thought, fucking ideal. So I said to Rab, go over and ask her for a dance. He said, no, I said, I don't want to. He said, get on. I said, fuck's sake, even she can't knock you back, can she? He says, all right, I will, see. So he went over to her and he said, excuse me, would you like to have a dance? She said, fuck off. He said, hey, what's up? She got a fucking green ear, looked like a cunt. He says, well, you got a fucking green lip. She said, it's not fucking oven. The next act is set in a courtroom, just to make George Petty feel at home. Would you please welcome the laughing policeman, and would you all rise, please, for the Right Honourable Judge Lionel Nutmeg. Get up!
He said he's sorry.
Constable Pants, would you like to tell me and the court what happened on the 14th of Wednesday, December last, which led to you making a pillock of yourself and your resentful arrest?
Yes, sir. Can I consult my notes?
Yes, you may.
On Wednesday, 14th of December last, approximately 10:43 a.m., while patrolling along the strip of the High Street, I observed a motor vehicle parked outside the ongoing Clement Adley Massage Parlour. I questioned the occupant, Mr. Jack E. Stewart, who said, urinate off you if you love, child. After a while, Mr. Stewart apologised and offered me a yellow candy-covered confectionery, known to the boys in the uniform branch as a smart E. I accepted the said smart E and swallowed it. A smart E which I now know contained an hallucinogenic drug. 35 minutes later, while sitting aboard an intergalactic spaceship, I am for the planet Zanussi, I observed Constable Parrish approaching me, disguised as a fortnight's holiday in Benidorm. Hello, Constable Parrish, I said, through the back of my neck. What news of my Lord Buckingham? To which Constable Parrish replied, get down off that bus shelter, you stupid git. And they thanked Constable Parrish. His notebook exploded, releasing 1,000 tiny giraffe heads on little penguin bodies. I was enticed down from said bus shelter by the very lovely Miss Marilyn Monroe, former screen starlet. We kissed informally. Then Marilyn, sweet, tender Marilyn, revealed herself to be a Mr. Brinsley O'Connor, a scrap metal dealer from Pickham. A panda car flew past, and three large uniformed pandas got out. I was charged by Police Constable Warren for gross indecency, impersonating a Spaniard, and acting the goat.
Also, eating a police constable while in the course of his duties. I then burst into hysterical laughter, which lasted 5 months. And that, my lud, is the truth, the old truth, and nothing but the truth.
Well, Constable Pants, I think I'll try you here myself and censure you myself. I find you guilty of being a total and utter pillock and a menace to society. I therefore...
No, my lord.
Sentence you to endless watchkeeping of Lieutenant Wingrove.
I couldn't imagine a whole Sods opera without some mention of shagging. I remember my first encounter with the old beaver. Been that fucking long ago. Hear yourself. The sheer yearning just to see the jolly old thing for the first time. I remember my first date, I took this bird out, took her to the pictures like all clean living guys do. Took her back home on the doorstep and I start trying to get the old hand down to see where this beaver is. She says to me, you can't, she says. Me mum and dad's in, she says. And besides, you'll have to go to the chemist first. She said, come back Sunday. Have dinner, me mum and dad go to church in the afternoon. We'll have the house to ourselves. Wink, wink. Put your fucking on. So Sunday I come back to dinner, beautiful dinner. Being the creepy ass bastard that I am, I give the mum a box of chocolates. Thank you very much. In the afternoon, right enough, 2 o'clock, mum and dad gets up, puts their coats on, we're off to church. So I get up, I put my coat on, I said, if you don't mind, I'll come with you. The look on her face was fucking amazing. She pulled me to one side, she says, you didn't tell me you were fucking religious? I said, you didn't tell me your old man was a fucking chemist. I still hadn't seen the thing. My brother said to me, look mate, if you want to see this beaver, he said, you're going to have to do a bit better than that. See, when you take this next bird out, he says, take her out of the town. He said, have a good swally. He said, you have a good swally, get her back home. They always feel like it on a drink. I said, we'll have a go at that. So I went up to town, had about 8 pints. Went back, quiet night, of course. Went back to her house, and we're on the sofa. Start to undo the old gear, like, you know. And I said, fuck me. I said, I need the toilet. So I get up and go up the stairs. She said, don't go up the fucking stairs. Don't go up the stairs. They creak. You'll wake me dad up. I said, go in the kitchen. So I went in the kitchen. 10 minutes later, I opened the kitchen door. I said, you got any paper? Still haven't seen it. About a month later, I couldn't believe my luck. I'm on this train going down south, and opposite me is sat this bird with the biggest pair of fucking tits you have ever seen. And she got this little black mini skirt on that she'd just as well not have on. And I could just see the fucker. I'm like this. She could see me perving her, it was obvious, you know, so she gave her old fucking wiggle of the ass, you know, and the skirt came up, and there it fucking was. For the first time in my life, I could see the fucking beaver, and I start breaking out in a sweat. She leans over the table, she says to me, do you want to see it wink? What? Do you want to see it wink? I said, fucking do I? Sure enough, the fucking thing winked at me, fucking amazing. She says, do you want to see it pout? I said, do what? She said, pout. I said, go on then. So sure enough, this fucking thing blew me a kiss, man. I went, that lady is fucking amazing. She says, she just sensed I hadn't seen it before, you know. She says, do you want to stick your fingers up it? I said, fuck me, can it whistle as well? The next act tonight, gentlemen, is based on that ever popular game show, The Generation Game. It will no doubt call for some more audience participation. Okay, so don't be shy. You too can look a cunt. Okay, so get up if you're asked to. You've heard of Bruce the Chin Forsyth. Well, for tonight's Reso's Generation Game, please welcome Daisy the Hooter Adams.
Nice to see ya, to see ya.
Nice!
Thank God that worked. I was fucking struggling there, I tell you. Anyway, just excuse the words for now. Right, tonight's generation game will consist of 3 games and the participants will be decided from you. I have a box somewhere. Here it is. I'll just move my shit from it. There will be three games. The first game is a manual karaoke, so you'll have to bear with me, okay? I've got come caught somewhat by surprise. Anyway, as I said before, all the participants will be picked from this box, okay? I would like you to pick the first contestant. The first contestant is somebody with the initials Xavier Onassis. XO. Come on down, sir. As I said before, the first game is a manual karaoke. What I'd like to do is, the XO has kindly volunteered to sing the verses, and I'd like everybody to join in the chorus.
It started just...
Recognize the words. Okay? If you'd just like to take this down, I will hold the words up for you, and you just...
She's rather unorganised, but I was caught somewhat by surprise. I thought Tony could waffle more than this.
I'm taking home a baby, thanks my mummy, be surprised with me. I'm taking home a baby,
right, sir, why don't you give her off? Stand by, because we're about to play. Here's the words, you just sing along. When it gets to a gap, you just shut up and everybody else will sing. Okay, sir?
Now, look for the bare necessities. Bare necessities to get much away than your style. I mean the bare necessities of Mother Nature's recipes. When the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found out of my big home. The bees are buzzing in the trees to make some honey just for me.
Stop.
When you look at the roads you pass and take a glance at the fancy ants and maybe... The bare necessities of life will come to you.
The bare necessities of life will come to you.
They'll come to you.
They'll come to you.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your time. I mean the bare necessities of Mother Nature's recipes. And drink the bare necessities of life.
Now when you pick a pawpaw, or a prickly pear, and you pick a pawpaw, well next time beware. Don't pick the prickly pear by the paw. When you pick a pear, try to use the claw. But you don't need to use the claw when you pick a pear of the big pawpaw. Have I given you a clue?
There's jig and dancers. Hey, fucking love jig and dancers. Keep going.
The necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you.
Where's the passport on this thing? It's on his off the cuff. Keep going.
I've not had this much exercise for years.
That's what he said.
This is really limited.
So just try.
You've got another go yet, lads.
Cool. Fall apart in my backyard.
It's what the man who's seen the video.
You're working too hard. And don't spend your time looking around for something you want that can't be found. When you find out you can live without it and go along not thinking about it, I'll tell you something true. The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you.
Hey, that's...
For the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. The bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities of Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life.
Thank you very much, sir. That was different. I have one more song. It is very apt for one particular person on board. I think the senior rates may well know who he is. I do hope he is here tonight. Yeah, can't even speak. Well, there we go. Is my best friend, the man who never slags me off here, Martin Solomon. Is he here tonight? Please. He's not here. He's racked out, isn't he? Oh, well, that only leaves one person. Frank News, come on down. Terribly sorry. There's two other people as well. The WEO, come on down. And the junior race equivalent. Sandy, come on down, pal. Bastard? I'm not a bastard. I'm not my dad. If you'd just like to stand over there, please. Over there as well, please, sir. Frank, first verse. Sir, second verse. Murray, third verse. Everybody, join in the chorus. The chorus is there. Thank you very much. Just hold on. Can everybody read that? What do we know? If you can't, touch it.
Stand by, Frank.
I'm too sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. To
cat, too sexy.
very much, gents. Nice to impress you. Where is it? Where is the coffee? Where is it? Right then, gentlemen, for the second game, it's just a small game of cake decoration. Should be quite funny, but there we go. I would like to welcome on stage, if you please put your hands together, for the Galloping Gourmet from Gala Shields, the King of Cuisine, direct from the kitchens of the Resolution Ritz, Scotty! Scotty, here he comes. Keep clapping, gents, keep clapping. So what you need to do is just observe what this superb expert is about to do, and then what I need you to do is copy it soon after. No problem, sir, no problem, don't worry about it. Right then, Scotty, if you'd just like to carry on, what he's going to do is just decorate the cake for you. No problem, just take about 2 minutes. I'd just like to explain what you're doing, okay, Scotty?
I don't really know.
Cheers, man.
I've seen the leading cook doing this a couple of times, so I thought I'd just
kind of
copy him.
Copy the leading cook? This should take long.
As you've seen, the night worker made the cake. Anyway, this is a very, very delicate operation, as you can see.
Can you all hear him?
As only qualified personnel.
Can you imagine the phone?
No, I like microphones, sir.
This stuff, as you know, is... I've always stuff for but I wouldn't do that bit here, as you know, because there's delicate equipment about, as you can see.
You meant to do that?
I'm so sorry.
I think he's about to add the lemon curd to the sponge, yeah? Lemon curd to the sponge.
To add the filling to this delightful.
Is that added? Can you just move this out of the way so that everybody can see? Because they might want to do this at home when they get back, so they won't. It's just adding the lemon curd to this delightful sponge.
Yes, that you're yes, going yes. to enjoy later.
Mm-hmm. Apparently, it's going on the counter later on for everybody to eat. So, best you try some. Is that not enough?
No,
he's adding some more, adding some more. And he's just about there, the second layer of it. Quality. I've done this before, haven't you? And add some more to the top. You've got about 20 seconds left, you're running out of time, I'm not rushing you, I'm not sure. Should we get rid of this?
Can't do
that. Look at this. I think it deserves a round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you. You could pick the shit. He's about running to the sides now, to the sides. I could be a bingo presenter, couldn't I?
Should be.
Quality, Scotty, quality. You can drive my Corsa anytime. Should we just move this out of the way, because I don't want to ruin everybody's view. He's nearly finished. I think he's got about 20 seconds left. He's run out of time.
Right, there you go.
Hey! You thought we were getting hot dogs, by the way, James. You've got to share this between 163 people this evening. Just throw a little fucking... Right. Did you get that, gents?
Yes.
No problem? Right. Have you got the two, is it just one, is it? Or have we got one for each one?
I'll give it to you.
Did you? Yeah. Oh, shit. This is one of those. Where's two... There they are. Amy O1, get a group. Come on.
He does frequently. There you go.
Right then. What can I do for this? That's happening on your words, sir. That's okay. What we need to do is just to make, because that looked quite easy, didn't it? I mean, I reckon I could do that, no problem. Okay, sir. So what we're going to do is we're going to blindfold you both, just to make it a bit more fun. Okay, sir. So if you'd like to come around this side, Waxy, you want to stand there? Cockney wanker. And kill myself. Right, sir. Can I have a sir? Could you put the blindfold on the surpasser, please? Thank you very much. And I'll put the blindfold on, Cockney wanker. Wait, you just hold that and don't talk too much, right? Because it might blow the amplifier.
Good evening, gents. I'm not from London.
Luton. Too real. No, I've been that one. OK, so can you just tell me if you can see my hand? No, right then. Mercy, can you see my hand?
No.
I didn't mean you, good pal. Right then. Where's the old mix? Scotty, I need you to put the stuff in the mix, man. I'm not that clever.
Well, that's part of the job.
Oh, God, is it? Where's the two bits of fake? Where's the two thingies? Right. Sir? That's for you. You know what that is, because you're a supply officer and you're meant to be an expert at this bloody thing, all right? Bexy, you're a steward and you're not an expert at anything, but... I'd just like to give me your right hand. There is the ladle. I believe that's the correct term. The ladle with the cream on the end. You need to put it in there. Once you put it in there, squirt it on there and away you go. So you've got about 2 minutes. Oh, 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 steady. I've just got to explain to Bagsy because he's a bit slow. Bagsy, when the boss has finished, okay, grab that ladle, top that up, squirt it on there, all right? Just like to point out that the there was a prize. I won't disclose the prize just yet, sir, or Bagsy, okay? And the marker will be P.O. Nev Carter, okay? Quick round of applause because you never get to that. 2 minutes on the super synchronous clocks so every single one on board reads exactly the same time. Not. Okay? Stand by, 2 minutes, go. Go on, sir. Bagsy, just wait there. No, stand still, you can't see what you're doing, mate. Just stand still. That's enough, sir, that's enough. Right, away you go. Bagsy, there's the thing just there. Have you got it? No, Bagsy in the bloody bag, mate. Go on, sir. That, hey, hey, it's pretty good, sir. That's enough, Bagsy. Right, go on, Bagsy. You want the old, switch the old lemon curd on. That's enough, sir. Get on the other one, get on the other one. Are you sure you can't see? Are you sure you can't see? Right, sir. That's enough. Oh, go on, do whatever you want. Go on. Go on, boss. Keep going. Right, put the cream on, I need a nice pattern, Got about a minute left. Keep going. Oh, thanks. Thanks, it's a good job you're blindfolded, otherwise you wouldn't have an excuse. Oh, sir, anywhere on the table, though. Come on, Bagsy, hurry up, man. Yeah, anywhere I do. Come on, Bagsy, nice and neat. We're down to the last minute now. Should be finishing off. How did you get that so late? You may laugh. Right then, Bagsy. Come on, Bagsy, we need to get on the old chocolate now, mate. The old chocolate. No. That's the chocolate. Go on, then, sir. All right, finish. We're down to the last 20 seconds. We'll just remove this stuff from the table because you don't need that anymore, do you? Come on, Bagsy, put the little chocolate on. Rav, I'm sorry about your musical gear down here, by the way. You popped it. Yeah, OK then, right, we're finished here. A big round of applause for the two contestants. Yeah. Please, thank you. Right, it's just like to remove your blindfold. Bagsy, yours is off, sir. Yours, remove your blindfold. Right, just like to stand in front of the table there. Just move this table back so everybody can see what's going on. Well, sir. Indeed. Right then, gents, we'd just like to welcome onto the stage the expert culinaire on board, Mr. Nev Carter. Where is he? Thank you, Nev. Right then, gents, we'd just like to... Nev, stand in the middle, please. Bagsy, just stand there. Sir, just stand there. If you'd just like to go on the other side, Scotty, because... Right, let's just get everyone on stage. I've seen this on the telly. If you stand on that mark there, OK, because the cameras can't get you. So, come this way, Nelson. That's it, spot on, sir. Right. This is Bagsy, just there. Right, Mark's out of ten.
That's not bad, is it? He's got the cream in the right position.
Watch of it.
It's a bit crap, like, but there's too much filling for the start. All right? There's too much chocolate on top. That's for my chocolate biscuits that I'm going to be unloading later on. The cream looks like something that came out the end of something like this shape.
Don't be on board, that's small, are they?
You are.
Mark's out of 10.
Keep looking. I know, sneaking a little look in the shelves. No, I'll give this 8 out of 10.
Yeah, so not bad, James. If we just go to this side, please, can I feel... Wait, hold on, I'll just kneel down.
You're
like, cos? Feel good.
What a mess. Just look at that. Look at that. I mean, that's disgusting, isn't it? I mean, it's a gross misappropriation of government property. A gross misappropriation. A gross misappropriation of government property only deserves one thing, gents, doesn't it?
Yep.
Carry on now. Thank you, sir. If you'd just like to take a seat, just over there somewhere. just eat your way to your seat. Thank you very much. Right then, gents. Scotty, thank you very much. Just a round of applause for Nick Carter, Scotty. First contestant is my cleaning oppo, LMEM, Stu Burgess. Come on down. The second name, that master of dexterity, Taff Lloyd. Come on down. Taff, please be here. Otherwise, you shouldn't be down the ball of shit.
Right, Bender.
He's right. Whiffs. Come on, Whiffs. You're there. I spotted your belt.
Hey.
Yeah. Round of applause for Whiffs. Come on. Hey. It's the slippiest deck in the world. Anyway. Right, gents, what I want to do is watch the DMO, because he's bragged about this continuously for 8.5 weeks, and it really gets on my tits. So, sir, if you'd just like to carry on, just demonstrate to the audience. These guys will catch on in a minute. Just what you do.
A few basic tricks, just a straight juggle like that, or you can kneel down, and you can get it going quite nicely. The one going up that side on its own, if you really want.
Or you can come back a bit. What?
What happens then is the captain rings up the consortium and says, "Yeah, there's banging in the boat, can you please stop the DMO from juggling?"
Oh, sir, keep going.
With your silver balls you're playing?
Not as good as Michael Caine.
I don't know.
It's all for you. Oh,
hello, sir. Oh, carry on, sir. I need you a bit longer. Yeah, I've lost my bloody props here. Keep going, sir.
Lost.
Oh, that'll do, that'll do. All right, sir. The first man up is Stu Burgess. Stu, just grab those. What I want you to do, sir, what I want you to do is, if you'd just like to stand over there, Stu. Sir, just stand there. Demonstrate a trick. This man will attempt to copy you. Okay?
Attempt
to copy you, okay? So the first trick, carry on, sir.
Straight start.
Thank you very much, sir. Stu?
Drum roll.
Chris Randall. Come on, Stu, I need you. Where are you going?
You can do it with free cans.
I know you can.
Straight into it.
Come on in, Stu. Busy in MS2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe you've been.
You can
play with my balls.
Call him Whiffs. Okay, no, I can't. Are you? One more go. I saw you doing the donk shop when you're that busy though. I saw you doing it. Go on. Yeah, not bad. Right, sir, second trick.
Okay,
if I watching, gents. Oh, bloody hell. Didn't see that one. Didn't see that one.
Yes,
come on, Stu. You convinced me you could do this one.
I can't do this one.
How lucky you told me you could. No, you got nailed down. And then took.
That's it.
Come on, one more go, quick. I've got the middle, hurry up. Kneel down. Yeah, that'll do. Come on, Chris.
Don't
see
your
hands, Chris. Oh, you kneel down first then. Fucking a book bastard. Just stand there, gents. Right, sir. I need you to. We've got a challenge for the winner, okay? But I need you to decide out of these two who won.
I reckon the winner's got to be...
LME Burgess. Right, LME Burgess, I've got a wee trick for you to do. This is a bit more technical, okay, because you're a bit of a flash bastard. What I need you to do is juggle, okay, blindfolded with two eggs. Are you sure you can handle that?
Oh, I don't know about that.
I'll have a go. You'll have a go. Okay, then. Whiffs, would you just like to tie that blindfold onto him, please? I
Are you ready? Can we have 2x, please? Fucking hell, I didn't think we had that many on board.
It's all fresh, it's all right.
One egg.
Then you'll come with us or
something? I've got one in the hand. One in that hand, just move slightly forward up because I can really fuck Rob Stewart up here and you'll never be able to play a single note. Okay? What I want you to do is just throw that one to that hand, that one to that hand, that one to that hand, that one to that hand. 5 times, that's it. Okay? And I'll never give you a re-scrub it again, okay? Go. Thanks a lot. Right, okay then. Can we have a round of applause, please, gents? Because he did change my
What about the DMEO doing it?
The DMEO? Well, I'm not sure. Yeah, we'll have to have a vote on this. Yeah. All those who say no, the DMEO shouldn't do it, shout aye. All those who think the DMEO should do it, shout aye.
Aye!
Well, sir. Come on down.
Afraid.
I'll just move this. No, it's not really. I'll just move these microphones out of the way. Can someone help this minute, Wes?
Practice this,
Clark. See, one more for practice. Oh, yeah, practice, sir. You kept bragging in manoeuvring that you could very well do it. Machine. Just get 2x.
Blindfold, please.
Give it the blindfold, please. Right, stand by, sir. Just make sure the blindfold's on. Nice and tight because. How many do you want?
Three.
You want? Hold
on the count of three. These
hold
are
it.
On the floor.
Stand by. We need a quick count through. We need everybody to count there, okay? Otherwise, it'll just lose its. It might lose, but it'll lose it. Okay? After three. One,
two, three.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
And of course, the DMEO. Sir, if you put my write-up on the side. Well, I'm sorry about this. I didn't think it would make this much mess. Anyway.
Look back on these patrols, and most of us will probably only remember the good times. I think the time I'll remember this trip. And you'll know about this if you live in the upper bunk space, is when you wake up in the morning with a picture painted on your ass, very precisely put with a permanent marker, thanks to the chief stoker bastard. I can think back, you know, in later life, I'll say to the missus when we go to bed, darling, when I'm asleep tonight, would you paint a picture on my ass so that when I wake up in the morning, it'll remind me of the chief stoker. I'm not sure if it'd be the picture or the arsehole, but something will remind me of the chief stoker. I heard Paddy Cummins and Paddy Robertson, two men of no fixed abode, talking in the annex the other night, and Paddy Cummins said to Paddy Robertson, he says, OK, he said, what are you going to do patrol weekend? He said, oh, I've thought about it. He said, actually, what I'm going to do is I've got to go down to Heathrow and pick up my brother. And he said, is that the brother you tell us about that's been in Australia for 30 years? He said, yeah, that's him. He said, the hairdresser. He said, look, there's a photo of his shop. Look, you can see that's his shop. Look, haircuts while you wait. He said, well, what's the point of you going all the way down the fucking Heathrow if you haven't seen him for 30 years? He said, he'll never recognise you. Boy, he said, what's the use of you going all the way down the Heathrow? He says, you'll never recognise him after 30 years. He said, I won't have to fucking recognise him, will I? He'll recognise me, I haven't been anywhere. Chief Stoker says to Paddy, what are you going to do this patrol weekend? He said, I'll tell you what I'm not going to fucking do. He said, I'm not going over to Ireland again. He said, I went over there last patrol weekend to see me mate, O'Reilly. Got over there, fuck me, O'Reilly. Went and got himself blown up in a pub. So the police said to me, look, would you mind coming down to the pub and identify O'Reilly for us? So he said, well, no, that's not a problem. He said, well, the only problem is, he said, actually, it is a problem, because all that's left of him is his head. So when he gets down there, the inspector came out the pub and O'Reilly's head like that. And he said, right, Paddy, he said, is that O'Reilly? He said, no, sir, that is definitely not O'Reilly. He was never that tall. I was hoping that Chief Solomon was going to be tonight. Lucky bastard, miserable cunt. You think he would? He won the Grand National or something. Well, the horse won the Grand National, but he had the horse, you know. But he probably is shagging it, yes. I was hoping he was going to be here because there was a bit of news, if he was listening to the football results tonight, that Celtic.
Yay!
Hey, Celtic, well, I knew there'd be one. There's always one, I see. Celtic has been offered a sponsorship from Spillers. Now, they were going to accept it until they realised they'd be going around with shirts with Win a Lot on it. Right, Jez, the next couple tonight are definitely out of Gart Naval. They've appeared on every submarine health and safety audit you can think of. Yes, they are that fucking interesting. Please welcome Hollywood Showers.
One, two.
Thank you.
Good.
Take it away, Maestro.
What is a Hollywood shower? I've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower. There's a place on Phoenix we all know, where all the smelly people go to wash their bodies and clean their teeth with the Clint Eastwood and leave and clean. What is a Hollywood shower? What is a Hollywood shower? I've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower. Now water is a precious thing, because we take more out than we put back in. But what have you got to fear when your bat's been flashed by Richard Gere? What is a Hollywood shower? What is a Hollywood shower? I've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower. In the cubicle for a shower, for at least a fucking half an hour. If someone pushes in, don't moan, you'll be Claude Van Damme or sliced alone. What is a Hollywood shower? What is a Hollywood shower? I've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower. I have this shower for a quick rub down. It gets like this in Tinseltown. Rounding there with a great big stiff, cause you get rubbed down by Mandy Smith. What is a Hollywood shower? What is a Hollywood shower? I've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower. Now it's off to bed for a few hours rest, with all the stars and not the best. It comes to the shakes, we don't moan, cause we're going on watch with Sharon Stone. What is a Hollywood shower? What is a Hollywood shower? We've been in this cubicle for half an hour, but I still don't know what's a Hollywood shower.
Ladies, thank you. Together live for this, the last ever show. For this occasion, we have on board by special DSRB delivery, Graham, the rambling ramble of cameraman from Challenge Annika. He is currently waiting to start in the main machinery space with the camera rolling. So let's see where he is exactly.
Sometimes they just come in simple conversation. I remember talking to Jimmy once, just the once, outside the annex. And I said to him, how's the plane coming on, sir? And he said, well, I'm having a bit of a problem. You remember this? I'm having a bit of a problem. He said, when I'm at home, I make the glue up, it lasts for 3 hours. When I'm at sea, it lasts for 30 minutes. You've got to try and stop sniffling, sir. I know the odds. Well, there's a classic back on watch. I'm the DMEO, Chief McNeil. I'm not paid to be popular. We should be on a nice little fucking earner there, sir. Well, the Chief Stoker for the Wrecker Owl. He's all true, by the way. Chief Stoker to the Wrecker Owl. He said, fucking Sean Nobby, he said, last trip. We were smoking, but I have freon levels in this. Yeah, well, the last captain wasn't fucking shagging Virginia Bottom Knee, was he?
Am I shagging Virginia?
That's what he said, sir. Right? All over Pisces, there were some interesting ones, yeah. Hydraulic bursting in the TG ring. TG manoeuvring. What's the hydraulic burst on? MEM Baldassare. It's on my fucking part of ship, sir. The favourite one, it's got to be the favourite one. Do you hear there? The smell of burning is coming from the fire. There is no risk of a galley on board. I think the one occasion I'm going to remember this trip, it's got to be Easter Sunday. Now, Mass, Communion, I think, very apt, very proper. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm fucking sure we were practising nuking someone on Good Friday. And we even went back Easter Monday to make sure we got the fucker. And I think I'm right in saying that the Good Friday Wizard was the last time anyone saw Petty Officer Adams on the casing, hanging out the Dobian. Right, without further ado, gentlemen, to get the second session off tonight's show after a swinging start, please show a resolution warm welcome to the singing duo Two's Company.
Surprise, surprise, there's three of us.
Very gracious of you. I mentioned to John Mullaney that we're back on because we totally only do one set. My side's not too good, don't tell the captain.
Glasses on, normally.
He said that.
Like Moore, Lennon and McCartney, sing if you know the chorus. We've got numbers all over.
Sing if you recognise the song.
Well, the Ukraine girls really knocked me out. They leave the West behind. The Moscow girls make me sing and shout. Georgia's always on my mind. Jolly round the snowy mountains way down south. Take me to your daddy's farm. Let me hear your battle records ringing out. Come and keep your comrades warm. I'm back in the USSR. Don't know how lucky you are, boy. Back in the US, back in the US, back in the USSR. Well, the Ukraine girls really knock me out. They leave the West behind. The Moscow girls make me sing and shout. Georgia's always on my mind. Beat a wish along my hand and you the place. Gee, it's good to be back home. Leave it till tomorrow to unpack my case. Honey, disconnect the phone. I'm back in the USSR. I'm the lucky one.
back in the US, back in the USSR.
Myself, I put it right in her hand, and if you come back,
the very next day. Then I'll understand,
riding on it.
Return to sender, address unknown. No such number, no such tone. We had a quarrel, a lover's spat. Our own, I'm sorry, but that letter keeps coming back.
She wrote upon it,
return to sender, address unknown. No such number, no such zone.
We don't sing a cowboy song, because I know there's a lot of cowboys out there. Right. Start off here. That's just to start up to my bit. From close to Robbie. Nice and quiet. The yellow bits are mine, the black bits are yours. And I'm going to hurt myself as well. Some people that work in manoeuvring might know this tree.
Make sure
you've got a new one now, okay? Hit it, Tom!
Help and more, wishes like I was by my side.
Big Fern's flying. Big Fern is flying to Bangkok on his way to visit his 19-year-old mistress, Sweetie Goosette. Could have been 90 Sweaty Gusset. But his, unfortunately for Big Fern, his plane comes down over the jungles of Africa, and he quickly gets located by a group of cannibals out hunting. Well, they pick up Big Fern. Big Neil Robinson, they pick up Big Fern and they take him back to the tribe. Now they obviously think that they're into a barbecue of a lifetime here. However, the chief of the tribe, B-13 of course, no local acting regulators in this tribe, John. He's got different ideas. He says to Big Fern, look, he said, Neil, mate, I'm going to spare you from the pot if you'll accept my challenge. Well, Big Fern, not being one to knock back a challenge, says, okay, I accept. So the chief says to him, he says, okay, he says, here, I've got three tents here. He says, in the first tent, that's full of the devil's potion. What's happening? He said, my tribe, they recovered this from a plane crash and they're drinking this and they're fighting and they're killing each other. I want you to go in there and drink it all. Big Fern said, no problem. In the second tent, he said, there's a lion. It's got a sore tooth. Okay, he says, when it gets agitated, kills all the tribeswomen. Yeah, I want you to go in to that lion and take his sore tooth out. No problem, Big Fern said. However, he said, in the third tent is the tribe whore. While all the women are down at the river doing their dobian, she's shagging with all the men, upsets them. I want you to go in there and I want you to shag her until she never wants to shag again. Big Fern. So he says, you've got till the sun rises. So Big Fern thought, well, I've got about 12 hours. So he goes into the first tent, and when he gets in there, it's fucking toppers with crates of Guinness. He fucking sees the lot off in 6 hours. He fucking comes out with. Goes in the second tent. Arf.
That's me lying.
Growl, growl, scratch, scratch, arf. Scratch, scratch, growl. Comes out 2 hours later, fucking cut to shreds. Blood and fucking snot everywhere. Right, he says. Where's this fucking whore with a sore tooth? My bit of Shakespeare coming up here now. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. Stand fast, Roger, right? You fucking keep yours watching. Rezzo's answer to William Shakespeare. Please welcome the Banzai Bard.
Hi-ya!
One, two, one, two. Fucking quality, fucking quality. Right. Here we go. I think you've all, everybody was on the patrol last time, knew that one. Fucking hell. Right, is there a wee-o in the audience? Shit, he is. I thought it was going to be unwatched then for a minute. But anyway, here we go. Going down the MC last Saturday night, a bearded wee-o asked me out for a fight. He was no bigger than a two-penny fart. He was a deft exponent of the martial arts. He gave me three warnings, trod on my toes, stuck his fingers in my eyes and kicked me in the nose. A rabbit punch made my eyes explode. My head went dead. I fell in the road. I pleaded for mercy. I wriggled on the ground. He kicked me in the balls and said something profound. Through rivers of blood and splintered bone, I crawled round the corner to the push-button telephone. I pulled a corpse out of the tech office, held back the bile, and with a broken index finger, I proceeded to dial. Couldn't get an answer. The phone was screwed. The receiver fell in half. It had been kung-fued. I didn't expect him to laugh, actually. A kung fu karate coxswain opened up the door, demanding information about the stiff on the floor. He looked like an extra from Yang Shang Po. He said, "What's all this now?" I saw, I saw, I saw. He wore a bamboo mask. He was genuine sin. He finished his devotions, then he beat me up again. I can't go back to the MC. The boys have got me on a mark. Enter the dragon. Exit. Banzai Bard. He's only going for a piss, he's just had a change, look. Right, another one here. I need to read the words on my sleeve here. Right, everybody's got one of these people in their departments who, for one reason or another, they don't particularly like. Right, I've certainly got a couple, but there you go. Put your own names to the what I'm going to say here. Like a nightclub in the morning, you're the bitter end. Like a recently disinfected shithouse, you're clean round the bend. You give me the horrors, too bad to be true. All of my tomorrows are lousy cos of you. You put the shat in shatter, you put the pain in Spain. Your germs get spattered about, your face is just a stain. You're like a death at a birthday party, you ruin all the fun. Like a sucked and spat out smarty, you're no use to anyone. Like the shadow of a guillotine on a debt consumptive's face, speaking as an outsider, what do you think of the human race? You went to a progressive psychiatrist. He recommended suicide before scratching your bad name off his list and pointing the way outside. You hear laughter breaking through, it makes you want to fart. You're heading for a breakdown, better pull yourself apart. Your bad breath, cramps, disease, destruction and decay. Please, 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 please take yourself away. People mention murder the moment you arrive. I'd consider killing you if I thought you were alive. You're certainly no raver, commonly known as a drag. Do us all a favour here, wear this polythene bag. You're like a dose of scabies, I've got you under my skin. You're like a fairy tale. Grim. You've got this slippery quality. It makes me think of phlegm and a dual personality. I hate both of them. Your dirty name gets passed about when something goes amiss. Your attitudes, platitudes just make me want to piss. What kind of creature bore you? Was it some kind of bat? They can't find a good word for you, but I can. Twat.
I was having a think there about the cannibal business. You know, I wonder if cannibals' wives used to nag them like our fucking wives nag us. You can imagine the cannibal coming home from a night on the piss, can't you? Goes in, goes to the fridge, fucking empty. Goes upstairs into the kids' room, eats the fucking kids. Goes and gets racked out at 3 o'clock in the morning, feel your old fucking guts going, you know?
gets out of his bed, dashes for the fucking window, up comes the window. And she starts to fucking wake up, don't she? That's right, you drunken cunt. A fucking fine way to bring the kids up. Gentlemen, never has so much expense been encountered in getting an act into a sod's opera before. Like £500 to be precise, a chap, you busted. This next act has travelled the world over. His magic is so amazing we don't even know how the fuck I got on board yet. If you think that's amazing, take a fucking look at this. The Great Soprendo.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the wonderful world of Patty. Stupid. Hold this a minute. Before I go on to our next act, I'd like to introduce to you tonight is Miss Playboy, Miss April, 94. Come in! Well, for my next act, I will require 4 volunteers. First volunteer. This is Tony McCall. Come in. Oh, we've got Paddy Jelly here. Come in. Come on down. Come on down. That's number 2. Well, number 3 we'll have. Daisy Adams. Daisy Adams? Yeah. Hey, come on down. Just like that. 500.
Hang on.
I'll just connect you up. For the next trick, this will require the fantastic, brilliant, superb, excellent, the Scully DeGraff generator. Just like that.
Just like
that.
Oh, you know,
I said you'd get his all back in one go.
Okay, the 4 volunteers are up. Could you hold hands, please? Okay, yeah, excellent.
Why should we put your
necks in here? Okay, here we go. Zip up and zip off. Zip up and zip off. Zip off. He's got it. Zip off is a juicy mouth. And now we require one person to go up and start the generator. Spot Boyle, he's a good guy. Come on up. Is he there? Is that now? He is. Oh, what a man. Come on, please, come on. Go places to the right, please. Let's get the generator in the view.
Oh, no!
Okay.
Find the intricate workings.
Okay. Countdown of 5 seconds. to start the generator, please. Count down 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and a solid generator! Oh, just like that! Ah, you're fucking solid generator! Solid generator! Sit down, clown! Sit down! Sit down! Oh, proper greedy up here. Proper greedy. Who should we have? Alan Cowie, come on down! Just like that. Okay. What? Are you ready? A little countdown of 5, please. 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Solid generator! Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Round of applause. Thank you. And now we're going to see if Sid the Silver Bull gets up and plays today.
Well, Sid's there. He's there. He's in. Come on, Sid. Whoop-a-tsa! Whoop-a-tsa!
One more, last one. I require just one volunteer. Could you go get my volunteer, please? Thank you. Just step there, sir. Sir, could I possibly have your watch? Watch. Starboard nipple. Very sexy.
No.
Prince, please. No harm will be done, sir. No harm will be done. No. An illusion. An illusion. Sir, present from whom?
From your missus.
From your missus? Just like that. Alright. We'll run out of time, sir. No, sir, no, I'm not. One watch. One rack.
Oh, you're
going to
fucking
smash it. Can everybody see the blue rag? The watch underneath. You see it? Can you see that? Yeah. There's your watch, sir. Don't we? There you go, sir. Thank you much. Thank you much. That's the end of the show. Thank you. Just one more thing. Doesn't keep watches anyway. Okay, thank you.
Does that watch work?
Nope.
Did he say he wasn't going to smash my watch?
Yes, he did.
Fucking Nick. I'll
get jobs and I'll arrest you for criminal damage. You didn't have to say unless you wish to do so. Did you say, pull me out of this in the court of law?
Now that is magic.
I love that one.
Sorry, sir, it's only local acting.
You can afford it, Megan.
The funny thing when Jack's pissed, you always have to. Oh, you're here again, are you? Is that your friend? Every queer's got a friend, it's alright. Isn't it funny, Jack, when he's pissed, he's always got to rip the shit at the ex-wife, isn't he? I was in the mess the other night with the coxswain. Weren't pissed, of course. Well, at least I wasn't, sorry. Anyway. You were talking about... Who let him in? Did he fucking smell then, as he got wind? I remember talking about the cops over a few drinks about ex-wives, and I said, I love the fucking day when we was on those, she was on those steps at the courthouse down in Plymouth. She'd just been fucked off by the magistrate, no maintenance money. She stood there and she said to me, she said, McConnell, you're a bastard. She said, I look forward to the day when I can dance on your grave. I said, so do I, bitch, I'm getting buried at sea. The coxswain says, yeah, he says, I remember mine well. I come home from work late one night, always soon after work, late in the maintenance period. Had a few drinks, I admit. But there she is, snug as a fucking bug, usual routine, in front of the telly, feet up. I knew she was going to come out with it. Coxswain, it's a bit like that in there, I suppose. It's me or the fucking Navy. Right, I'll wait for your fucking discharge note. CTM the world again. During that last maintenance period, I recall the MEO and the WEO coming to work one morning. I think it was just the one morning. Come into work and he said to the MEO, fuck this shagging lark, he said. Seems to be 20% pleasure and 80% graft, he said. I don't want to fucking bother. The MEO said, no, mate. He said, I think you're wrong. I think you'll find it's 50% pleasure, 50% graft. So they started fucking arguing. So the MEO said, fine, I'll ring up Charge Chief and Connell. He's back after, you'll know. So he rings me up and he said, I want you to settle me an argument. The WEO thinks that sex is 20% pleasure, 80% graft. I think it's 50% pleasure, 50% graft. I said, well, you're both fucking wrong, sir. If there is any grafting involved, you get me to fucking do it. I'm looking forward now, men, right enough, to the first night home. There's one thing I like about that first night home, he said, when you go up those stairs and you get racked out and it's fucking luxury, innit? You can lie there, yeah? You got someone to hold the duvet up for you while you're fucking yawning. Gentlemen, you've done it, haven't you? 5 popular request, gentlemen, they're back again tonight. Back to misuse us, abuse us, your Reso's answer to Hell and Pace. Please welcome Billy and Johnny.
Hello, Billy.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Before we start, everybody, we must warn you. The guilty will be persecuted. The names have not been changed to protect the innocent. Okay? Shall we begin?
So you better start shooting yourself out there.
Shall we begin?
Yes!
Okay. Welcome to Resolution. This is an SSBN, not an SSN or an O-boat.
Unlike O-boats, this boat is professional.
Yes, we are, Billy. We know a song about O-boats, don't we?
Yes, we do. Johnny.
Shall we begin?
Do you want to hear it, everybody?
Yes!
1, 2, 3. You can shove your fucking O-boats up your ass. You can shove your fucking O-boats up your ass. You can shove your fucking O-boats. Nothing but homo love boats. Shove your fucking O-boats up your ass. Okay, Billy, shall we see who's in the audience?
Let's below the props.
No, wrong ones. Round window. Shall we see you through the one window, Billy?
The one?
Is Steve Perry back on board?
I can't see him.
I can see the Chief Stoker.
The Chief Stoker?
Yes.
Chief said that if we take the piss out of him, he'll stop our tap.
Well, come on down, Chief Stoker. Stop our tap. Come on. Come and join us. He's a miserable bastard, isn't he?
It might take him a bit of time, because he's a silly old cunt.
There's one bit of machinery the Chief Stoker hates on board, Billy.
What's that, Johnny?
It's the mass spec.
Not the mass spec.
Certainly. Do you like the mass spec, Chief Stoker?
Oh, fucking idiot.
We know a song about the mass spec, Chief Stoker. Do you want to hear it?
Yeah.
Put two. This cigarette's Chief Stoker.
I don't smoke them, I smoke cigars.
Will do. Okay, Billy, shall we begin?
Let's begin.
You never light a fag anymore between your lips. And there's no nicotine stains anymore on your fingertips. The mass spec's trying hard not to show it. Smokers, but smokers, you fucking know it. We've lost a lot of freon. Oh, a lot of freon. We've lost a lot of freon and it's gone, gone, gone. Whoa, whoa. Fuck off.
Big hand for the Chief Stoker.
Let's see who's not through the square window, Billy.
Who's not through the square window, Johnny?
I don't know, can you tell me?
The only hob not here is the MEO.
The MEO?
Do you know a song about the MEO, Johnny?
I certainly do, Billy. I certainly do, Billy.
Who's your boss?
I certainly do, Billy.
See it then, Johnny.
Diddle-diddle. 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 He's lanky and he's skanky, he's altogether manky, he smells of dog breath, he's our MEO. Who's next?
Prop,
press one, hurry up. Oh, it's a hydraulic pump cutting, number one.
Number one?
It's a hydraulic pump cutting number two. A hydraulic pumpkin number three. Pumpkin. Pump cutting, Billy.
We know
some
about three pumps cutting in, don't we?
You certainly do, Billy. Do you want to hear everybody?
Yes!
Do you want to hear everybody?
Yes!
Shall we begin?
Let's.
One, two, three. You put the arse end in, the arse end out. You do the bise wily. Start again, Billy. You put the arse end in, the arse end out, you take the boat away and you sail around. Oh, we fucked up. Pin that one. Next. What's yours? You're on.
See, we hope. Well, sir, it's good to have you on the starboard crew. You're not on the last patrol anymore. Then the forends got picked up. Then you were a sub-lieutenant. We wish we had Dusty here, but unluckily he fell off a fucking roof. Why couldn't have you done that?
Bad job, Billy, and Luggy. You fucking dived there, didn't you? Look, Billy, I've got a request.
A request? A request for who, Johnny?
It's from the wife of Big Vern. It says, "Dear Billy and Johnny, my husband's a quiet lad. He never does nothing. Could you fix it for him? Become noisy."
I think we can, Johnny.
Could you come up and join us, please, Excel?
okay. To start, if anyone being noisy, Billy, is a megaphone. Knowing our XO, we've given one. To shout in the loud end. Also, as we know, Billy, from a noise short, you has to be monitored.
So we must have a noise short sign.
We certainly have, Billy. Stand over here, please, sir. That's positioned nicely. Oh, we've got a badge for the XO, look. Flying station's badge. He's only done two visits.
Both times.
There's a brooch of your own, sir.
About flying, don't we, Johnny?
We certainly do, Billy.
Do you want to hear it, everybody?
Yes!
1, 2, 3. Those magnificent men in their flying machines, they go up to the top, they go down to the up, down, broaching around, la di da, don't know the rest of the words. Thank you very much, sir. Oh, where's the wrong window gone?
Panicking.
Okay, but let's see who else is through the round window.
It's got to be a very large window so the next person to come up.
Is Frank Hughes in the audience?
He's on watch.
Ah, fuck it, we'll do it anyways. This next song is dedicated to Frank Hughes. Bear with us, please.
Steve, you don't need the trunk.
Okay, everybody. We know a song about Frank Hughes. Do you want to hear it?
Yes!
Shall we begin? Billy?
I think we ought to.
1, 2, 3. Two fast land. The submarine Reso came. They brought an intelligent elephant, and Frank was his name. One morning watch, he slipped old Harry's chains, and off he ran to back after was never seen again. Oh, Frank and the elephant packed his group and said goodbye.